So the fascinating thing about the Saw franchise, and when you're dealing with the traps, the horrific conditions that we place these characters in, they don't even want us to be thinking about the traps until the very, very end of the process.
The thing about traps always evolving is that was another time. You know, I think, believe it or not, in many ways, we know where our bread is buttered with those traps, but we'd love to sort of scale that. We want that to be evolving too. We'd like to sort of get away from these, you know, very elaborate traps, because a lot of times they feel forced. And I think we'd also just like to not make the movies all about the traps.
Over the years with the traps, when we started the first Saw movie, somewhat out of necessity because it was a low budget independent movie, our traps were kind of based on a concept of something that Jigsaw, John Kramer, built in his garage out of pieces of stuff that he found in the junkyard. And that was kind of the basic premise.
There is a way to save him, or you can keep him locked up and throw away the key. The decision is yours.
Throw away the key? What the fuck?
One of the reasons the traps in this movie look a lot different and feel different are John is an engineer. John Kramer was an engineer by trade.
Countless exposition monologues were paid to talking about how he was able to do what he was able to do, and that's his engineering background.
And when we started this one, we made a conscious choice to try to go back more towards basics.